Let's see some topical questions of the IGCSE topic polymerization in this video. So the first question says, draw the structure of a complex carbohydrate such as starch. The formula of a simple sugar that can be said as monomer also for this complex carbohydrate, which can be presented as here shown. Now here it has two OH group. Now in the polymerization we have already seen that we remove out water when we make such condensation polymers. So if we want to remove out water, we can remove out OH from one side of the monomer and H from the other side of the monomer and then join this as monomers altogether. So if we draw the polymerization, so let's start with a common group as it's been represented here, and then we have removed out the OH group, so we are left with only one bond, and from the other side we have removed only H, so we are left with O. Now let's draw an extended bond on both sides and then again join the monomer as such. So again the O comes here, so here is the O, again a general group here, and again an extended bond from the other side where we have removed out OH. So this is how we are going to get a polymer of a carbohydrate such as starch, and we can write n such molecules here. Such a simple polymer diagram will give us 3 marks, which includes the correct linkage, correct general group, the extended bonds, and the N here outside. The next question says, ethanoic acid and ethanol reacts to form an ester. What is the name of the ester? Now in naming the ester, we have already learned that the alcohol part is named first. So it is ethanol. So our name of the ester starts with ethyl. And then the carboxylic part, which should be written as ethanoate. So ethyl ethanoate is the name of the ester formed. Let's go ahead with the next sub question. It says, the same linkage is found in polyesters. Draw the structure of the polyester which can be made from the monomers shown below. Now here again, as we have seen earlier in this ester, here also there will be a polyester formed from carboxylic groups and the alcohol groups. The same method works here where we remove out the water to form the polymer. Now so if we look at the monomers, we need to remove out the OH group from the carboxylic monomer and only H from the alcohol functional group of the monomer. So if we join together these two parts of the monomers to make a polymer chain, then we need to start with the CO group of the monomer. So let's start with CO group and an extended bond, the C6H4, again the CO bond, and then let's start with the next monomer, that is starting with the O, then the between part, that is CH2, and then O. H we have removed out. Now draw the extended bond here and an extended bond here and a bracket, and this gives us the repeating unit of the polyester. And N can be added to show this, that N number of such repeating units are joined together to form the polyester. Again with the correct linkage and the correct polymer, you get 3 marks for such a question. Let's go ahead with the next sub question, which says, describe the pollution problems caused by the non-biodegradable polymers. We have many such pollution problems, but we need to mention only 2 pollution problems as it carries 2 marks. So we can write the first one as, it is dangerous to the animals. Dangerous to the animals in the sense when animals inhale, not inhale, sorry, they eat such polymers, then they may have some choking or other problem which may lead them to die. Now the second problem is they evolve poisonous gases when burnt. There are many other that it causes visual pollution, it is difficult to fill up the lands, so causes landfill sites problem, then it takes long time to decay in the environment. There are many such problems. We can mention any two problems here. The next sub question says, two macromolecules have the same amide linkage as shown here in the nylon. Nylon, a synthetic polymer, has the following structure. Now here is the polymer shown. Protein, a natural macromolecule, has the following structure. How are these two different? Now look at this polymer and look at this polymer, and we need to find out the difference between these two macromolecules, that is the polymers. Now looking at the two polymers, we can easily make out that in the nylon we have only two types of monomers, that is, one of the monomer is this and the second monomer is this. Now we can see that these monomers are getting repeated every time. While in proteins, we can see that every time the monomer is a different. So we can first point, we can write that in nylon only two types of monomers are used. Only two types of monomers used. But in proteins, many monomers, many types of monomers used. Because we know that proteins are made of amino acids, and we have 20 such amino acids which can be used in any sequence. Now again, if we have a look, we can make out that in the nylon the monomer have two CO group and two NH group, but in proteins it has one CO and one NH. Each and every monomer has one NH and one CO group. So the second difference, we can write that proteins have one CO and one NH group, but nylon have two CO and two NH groups or functional groups with each monomers. So two marks and two differences should be mentioned here. Now let's go ahead with the next question. Here is another question for alkenes. Alkenes can polymerize. Deduce the name and the structural formula of the monomer from the structure of the polymer. Now, the way we made a polymer from the monomers, from the structure of the polymer, we should also know how to make out the structure of the monomer. So, let's go ahead with this one. We can see that this is the repeating unit in the polymer, and we know that alkenes are the monomers here. So alkenes should have the double bond, and we should also remember that polymers made from alkenes should have only two carbon as the repeating unit. So what are we going to do is that first let's draw the structure of the monomer and then name it. So what are we going to do is draw this 2C here and add a double bond between them, because when it polymerizes, one of the double bond breaks and gets extended on both sides. So we are drawing this 2C and adding a double bond here, and then add the remaining atoms or group on these two carbons. So here we have CH3, H, H, and H. Now for monomer, we are not going to add this extended bonds. So now looking at the structure, we can make out that we have a chain of three carbons with double bond between the first and second carbon. So what we can name here is as prop 1 in, or we can name it as propene also, because in propene wherever the double bond we have, it can be named as 1 in only, but our chain contains three carbon atom with a double bond, so we name it as propene. We can also draw this monomer as a single long chain here, as we have added. So here is one H and here it is CH3. So this is propene. So we can draw the simplest structure of the monomer as propene here, and we can name it as propene directly without naming one in between. Let's go ahead with the next question. It says, draw the structure of the polymer formed from the following monomers. Now, this is the monomer and we need to draw the structure of the polymer from it. So, let's first study the monomer of the given question. Here, monomer contains one C double bond C and one of it is ester group also. Now to make a polymer, we should either have a C double bond C to get an addition polymer. We can also make a condensation polymer, but is it possible here? No, because then the monomer should have either the carboxylic acid at the end of the monomer and another monomer with an OH group, which is not present here. So our repeating unit should be these two C carrying the double bond. So let's draw the structure starting with these two C, but we are going to draw only a single bond between these two carbon atoms. Now during the addition polymer, the double bond breaks and gets extended on both sides. So we are drawing only a single bond between the two carbon and draw an extended bond on both sides. Now if this carbon carries two hydrogen, let's draw two hydrogen with the first carbon atom, and for the second carbon atom we have one hydrogen here and then this ester group. So we can write this as O, which is bonded directly with the carbon, then CO and then CH3, which is the second group on the second carbon atom. So this is our polymer unit. So what marks we get here is for the correct repeat unit, and we should not forget drawing the extended bonds on both the sides, which gives us another mark. Let's go ahead with one more sub question. It says, describe the pollution problems caused by the disposal of polymers in the landfill sites and by burning. We have seen a similar question earlier in the same worksheet here. Let's repeat it. It says, what pollution problems are caused at landfill sites? So we can see that the polymers do not decay for longer time. And as this carries two marks, we need to describe it that because of that it causes visual pollution. So we need to mention 2 points for two marks, two valid points. Now because of burning, it carries one mark. What pollution problem does it causes from burning? So on burning, it evolves toxic gases, or you can say a poisonous gases also, like HCl, or you can say carbon monoxide, and in some cases HCN also. But it's not necessary to mention the names of the poisonous gases. We can just write that it evolves toxic gases. Now let's go ahead with the third question. It says polymers are extensively used in food packaging. Polydichloroethane is used because gases can only diffuse through it very slowly. Polyesters have a high thermal stability and food can be cooked in polyester bags. Now the first sub-question says the structure of the polydichloroethane is given below. Draw the structural formula of the monomer. Now we know that it is a polymer formed from ethene because it carries only two carbon as a repeating unit. So the monomer should be drawn with the carbon carrying the double bond in between these two carbons. So we have drawn these two carbon carrying the double bond and the remaining atoms should be bonded to these two carbons. So we can write H2 here, double bond C, and two chlorine atoms here. So in other terms, we can also write as CH2 double bond CCl2. This is the monomer for our polymer. The next sub-question, explain why oxygen can diffuse faster through the polymer bag than carbon dioxide can. Now there is only one reason possible, that oxygen is lighter, or we can say that oxygen has lower molecular mass, lower MR in short we are writing, than carbon dioxide. Now if we want to write, if it is lighter, oxygen is lighter than CO2, then we get only one mark as it carries two marks. So in that case again, then we need to mention that MR, what is the MR of oxygen and carbon dioxide. But directly to get two marks, we can directly write that oxygen has lower MR than CO2, so it can diffuse faster. The next sub-question says a polyester can be formed from the monomers as shown here, and this one, draw the structure of this polyester. Now such in polyester we have already drawn earlier, but let's repeat here again. Here OH group from the carboxylic functional group should be removed and H from the alcohol group should be removed and directly joined. There is no other complication. So if we start with the carboxylic part of the monomer, then we can write with OC extended bond here, then C6H4, the middle part of the monomer, and then again the CO group. Now here we are directly joining this O, so it should be written here, and then the middle part of the next monomer, that is CH2 CH2, and then O, and then the extended bond. Now here it's not mentioned that draw two repeating units or one repeating unit, so we are drawing only one repeating unit. This is one whole repeating unit joining two monomers. So here we are drawing two extended bonds and a bracket and the repeating unit with N. Now this is called polyester because it has an ester linkage here in the polymer. So this is called polyester. Let's go ahead with the next sub-question. It says name a naturally occurring class of compounds that contains ester linkage. So naturally class of compounds are fats and lipids which carries the ester linkage. So that's our answer, which carries one mark. So here we have discussed three big questions with so many sub-questions about the polymers of IGCSE topic. Now to get the PDF of this worksheet, you can go to the description of this video and download it from the link given, and you also should not forget the videos made on addition polymerization and condensation polymerization.